Today, we're going to talk about the number one reason that stops people from getting what they want. Let's get started. Welcome to Coffee with Marcus. Today, with my favorite coffee mug, the one from my daughter Vivian. A high five from Vivian. Yes, she painted this herself. So, love it. Today's topic is the number one reason that stops people from getting what they want. And what is this? It's the lack of focus. Yes, I prepared a few cards for you today. So, the lack of focus is stopping people from getting what they want. People who focus on what they want, they prosper. People who don't, struggle. So let's think about it. Let's say you want to make more money, right? So what are the ways that we can make more money? In my book, there are three ways to make money. Running a profitable business, investing in real estate, or of course, trading. And by trading, I mean stocks, options, futures, binary options. It doesn't really matter. So let's talk about business first, right? Many people start several businesses in their lifetime and fail. I hear from people who are starting a business about selling greeting cards, right? And then they have a garage full of greeting cards and it doesn't work well. So the next thing they move on is maybe selling candles. You know, these MLM businesses, they're all around, right? And this is when they invite people and say, oh, you want to buy my stuff? Okay. Or they might have a great idea to start a business, but they're not taking it seriously. And this is why a business failed. Let's talk about real estate. You might have heard it when looking for real estate. Same as in trading. You are looking for properties that are cheap, that have the best potential. And this means, yes, you have to make several calls to people. You have to put in several contracts. When I used to buy single family homes, it was not unusual that I passed on four, five, maybe six opportunities before I finally bought a house that I thought was a great opportunity to put renters in. Now, when I moved on to apartments, I know that before I bought my first apartment, I looked at 12 apartment houses, 12 apartment complexes actually, to make sure that I found the one that's fit. But you see, I was determined and I had the focus. Now, when it comes to business, for me personally, I am fully committed to Rockwell Trading. As you know, this is my business because I know that this is where I can help you to make more money. With these tips, obviously, and then if you're interested in learning how to trade stocks and options, yes, I'll be happy to show you this. Now, let's keep talking about trading. If you are interested in trading, let me ask you just honestly, how many webinars did you attend? How many trading strategies did you check out? I mean, you know, right now as we are recording this, cryptocurrencies are just crazy. In December, everybody was all around cryptocurrencies. And even now, we are recording it today. It is January 17th. This morning in my inbox, I had 10 emails. 10 emails offering me a cryptocurrency trading course. So yes, I know that it is easy to get distracted, but here's what I want you to consider. Choose one strategy. Choose a trading strategy that makes sense to you. See, for many of the people who work with me, many of the traders, I recommend the Seahawk strategy. It's a day trading strategy for trading the futures markets. Now, if you can day trade, there's other strategies. Just let me know and I'll be happy to recommend some to you. But then focus on this one strategy. Trade it on a simulator. And we talked about simulators before. Yes, you can trade without risking a single penny. And this is what you should do for at least 40 trades. Keep a trading log. Write down what works and what doesn't. Evaluate. Okay. When did I make money? When did I lose money? As an example, for me personally, I make money in the mornings, not in the afternoons. This is what happened to me. I made some money in the mornings. Lost it in the afternoon. So, what is the easiest way to improve my trading? Stop trading in the afternoons. And that's what I do. I do not trade after 9 o'clock Central Time. My preferred trading time is between 7:30 and 9 or 8 and 9 o'clock. That's perfect for me and my style of day trading. I also do not trade on Fridays because that's what I realized, right? I made money Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and then I gave it back on Friday. So what's the easiest way? Stop trading on Fridays. But you see, this is, you will only see what works if you stay focused and don't get distracted. You see, that's a beautiful thing. It applies to all areas of life. It doesn't matter whether right now you're running a business or you're investing in real estate or when you're trading. Just think about it. How much further could you be in life if you would have just focused on one thing? By the way, that is an excellent book. There's a book from Gary Keller. It's called The One Thing, that actually helps you determine what the one thing is that you should be focusing on. And you see, in another coffee episode, we'll talk about what should you be trading based on your account size and your availability to trade. So we'll probably do this in one of the upcoming coffee episodes. But for now, I just want you to focus on one thing. And here's the important thing. Here are my notes. Not only focus on one thing, once you have identified the one thing that you want to do, commit to it. Okay? Just say, yes, I'm going to do this. If you want to make money with stocks and options or with trading in general, then put your head down and say, that's what I'm focusing on. And if there's a business opportunity coming along, pass on it. Say, not now. I'm going to commit to making trading work. And then, of course, you got to take action. And this is what I wanted to tell you. Yes, start on a simulator. You don't have to jump in right away. Okay, just stick to one style of trading. Stick to a trading strategy for at least 40 trades. After 40 trades, you're allowed to evaluate the trading strategy to see if it works or not. All right, so in summary, the lack of focus is the number one reason that stops people from getting what they want. People who focus on what they want prosper. People who don't struggle. So I invite you to focus, commit, and take action. All right. If this was helpful, like the video, share it with your friends who need to learn or hear this message. Share it with your friends who are right now all over the place and need to focus. You know who these friends are. Have a great day, and I will see you the next time.